wise old owl named Big Mama sat warming her feathers in the spring sun. She spied something hidden in the tall grass below her favorite oak tree. It was a baby fox. He had lost his mother, and now he was all alone in the world.
You poor little fellow. It's all right. Big Mama's here. You know, you're gonna need some caring for. Now, don't you move, honey. Big Mama's gonna be right back.
Big Mama hurried to find her bird friends, Dinky and Boomer. They were trying to catch a fat caterpillar for their breakfast.
Good work, Boomer. We'll get him this time.
Phew. Am I glad I found you boys. I need your help. Now, come on. Come on.
Let's go, Boomer. Come on.
Oh, shucks. Oh, poor little guy.
Don't you worry now. We're going to find someone to look after you.
Hey, I think I got an idea. You two make a bet. Go for it. Okay, Boomer, now you know what to do.
Yeah, leave it to me. Leave it to me.
Boomer flew to the farmhouse of kindly Widow Tweed. He tapped loudly on the door with his beak. Without warning, the door swung open.
Who is it? Well, I was sure I heard someone knocking. Wait, it's a baby fox. Oh, hello, little fella. I wonder where its mother is. I'm not going to harm you. No, I just can't leave you out here all alone. Oh, my. You're such a little toddler. That's what I'm going to call you. Todd. You know, Todd, I'm not going to be so lonesome anymore.
At a tumble-down shack nearby, a hunter named Amos Slade was returning from a trip to town. Over his shoulder, he carried a burlap bag that wiggled and jumped. He gently placed the bag in front of his dog, Chief.
I got a surprise for you, Chief, old boy.
Out of the bag tumbled a furry little hound dog, Puppy.
Well, how's this for a hunting dog? He's just a little runt now, but he'll grow. You may as well get used to him, Chief. He's for you to look after from now on.
In only a short time, Todd had become a full-fledged member of Widow Tweed's family.
I declare I never will get my chores done. You little imp. Now, run along and play. Go on, and try to stay out of mischief.
Hey, it's Pinky and Boomer. Maybe they want to play. Hiya, fellas. What you doing?
We'll see you later, kid. We gotta take care of some unfinished business. Is this it, Boomer?
This is the place. I never forget a tree. I never forget a tree.
We'll get away this time. Okay, Boomer. He's right. There. Let him have it. Yikes, watch it. Don't let the creek get away.
I think I bent my beak.
Now see what you've done. You cost us our breakfast.
I cost us our breakfast? It was your fault.
What are you talking, my fool?
Yeah. Oh, if it wasn't for
a worm for breakfast?
What do you mean? Go on, if you have.
Todd left the two birds to argue over the caterpillar. He didn't think much of having a worm for breakfast. Todd wandered into the woods near Amos Slade's house, where Chief was teaching the little puppy, now called Copper, to be a hunting dog.
Hey there, Copper. What you sniffing at?
Something I never smelled before, Chief.
Let me see. Ah, shucks, that's easy. The master just cooking grits and fat back.
That's not what I smell. I don't know, Chief. It's something else.
Sonny, you got a lot of learning to do about a sniffing and a smelling. Hey, where you going?
I want to find out what that smell is.
Okay, Copper, but the master ain't gonna like you wandering off.
I won't get lost, Chief. I can smell my way back.
Can't tell these young whippersnappers anything.
Copper sniffed his way into the woods. His sensitive nose led him around trees, over rocks, and right through a hollow log to where Todd was sitting.
What you smelling?
I'm on the trail.
Trail of what?
I don't know yet. Why, it's you.
What do you do that for?
We're supposed to do that when we find what we've been tracking.
I'm a fox. My name's Todd. What's your name, kid?
Mine's Copper. I'm a hound dog.
Chief, I bet you'd be good playing hide and seek. You wanna try, Copper?
I use my nose.
Try.
Okay, now go ahead and close your eyes and count. 1, 2, 3.
No, Copper, you can't peek. Oh. Now start again.
1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7.
My, look at that. A fox and a hound playing together.
When you're the best of friends, having so much fun together, you're not even aware you're such a funny pair. You're the best of friends. Life's a happy game. You could clown around forever. Neither one of you sees your natural boundaries. Life's one happy game. If only the world would get in the way. If only people would just let you play. They say you're both equal. You're breaking all the rules. They can't understand the magic of your wonder. When you're the best of friends, sharing all that you discover. When these moments have passed, will that friendship last? Who can say? There's a way. Oh, I hope it never ends. 'Cause you're the best of friends.
You're my very best friend. And you're mine too, Todd. We will always be friends forever, won't we?
Yeah, forever.
Copper! That mammoth, that copper pup's gone astray off again. Come on, Chief. After that little rascal's gonna make me a good hunting dog, he's gonna learn the mind. Copper! Get over here! Copper!
Uh-oh, I gotta go home.
You have to? We're having too much fun.
I gotta. He sounds awful mad.
I'll see you tomorrow, and don't forget. I won't.
But the next day, Copper didn't come to play. So Todd went to Amos's house in search of his friend.
Hey, Copper. What happened to you? Golly, you're all tied up.
Yeah, and it's no fun either. Master says I gotta stay home.
Well, we can play around here then.
Oh no, now it's old Chief over there.
Is that him making that awful noise?
He keeps me awake at night.
Oh, don't go in there. He can get awful mean.
He's cranky.
Gee whiz. Is he ever big? His ears isn't as big as yours, Copper. That's not the part you gotta worry about. Wow.
Look at those teeth. That's the bite they'll worry about.
I'm gaining on him. He won't get away now.
He's waking up. He's outside. Look, he's out of the tree. He's chasing
him. Well, I've got him cornered. Look, it's a big old badger.
Patrick, you see him, the badger?
No, it ain't a badger. It's a fox.
Run!
Todd shot out of the barrel. He tore across the yard and into the chicken coop. Chief slammed in right behind Todd, still dragging his barrel house. Chickens flew in every direction.
God bless it, he's getting away!
Just at that moment, Widow Tweed was driving by. Todd darted out of the coop and jumped into the back of her truck. He ducked behind some milk cans just as Amos fired his gun.
Amos Slade, you trigger-happy lunatic! Give me that gun!
Dagnabbit, woman, your thieving fox was after my chickens!
Rubbish and poppycock! I don't believe it. He wouldn't hurt a thing.
You calling me a liar? I saw it happen.
Amos Slade, that temper of yours is going to get you into a lot of trouble someday.
Temper? Temper, woman, you ain't seen my temper. If I ever catch that fox on my property again, I'll blast him. And next time, I won't miss.
From then on, Todd had to stay inside Widow Tweed's house for his own safety.
Poor little tyke. It's a shame I have to keep them cooped up. It's not my fault, you know. You caused them out of trouble. Oh, now what are they up to? Why, it looks like Amos is going on a hunting trip. A long one from the looks of it. Well, good riddance.
Amos was leaving. Copper jumped and barked excitedly as his master threw supplies into his battered old truck.
Well, Copper, me and old Chief are going to teach you all about hunting. Yes, sir. And it's about time, too. Atta boy. Yeah, you're really going to like tracking down those varmints for me. Well, boys, we're getting out of here till next spring.
Todd could not bear to see his friend leave. He squeezed out of the window and rushed over to Amos Slade's.
Todd, honey, what are you doing over here?
Gee, I just wanted to say goodbye to Copper, but I'm too late.
Well, what did you plan to do if you ran to Old Chief?
Aw, Chief, I can have Fox that dumb old dog anytime.
You listen good, Todd, because it's either education or elimination. Now, if you're so foxy and old Chief so dumb, then why does that hound get the fox on the run? Because he's got the hunter, and the hunter's got the gun. Kablam! Elimination. Lack of education. If you pile around with that power hound, you'll wind up hanging on the wall. Keep your nose to the wind and you'll keep your skin, because you won't be home when the hunter comes to call.
Oh, Big Brother, I know Copper would never track me down. Well, Copper, he's my best friend.
Your best friend. That Copper's gonna do what he's been told. Suppose you chase little fox in the old foxhole, and along comes the hunter with a buckshot load.
Kablam!
Lack of education.
You better believe it, Todd.
You mean Copper is gonna be my enemy?
I'm sorry, Todd. Honey, Copper's gonna come back a trained hunting dog. A real killer.
Oh no, not my friend Copper. He won't ever change.
I hope you're right, Todd.
And we'll keep on being friends forever. Won't we, Big Mother?
Darling, forever is a long, long time, and time as a way of changing things.
the autumn leaves fell from the trees. Before long, the woods were covered with snow. Dinky and Boomer gave up trying to catch that caterpillar. He had managed to crawl right through a keyhole into the widow's house. The birds looked in to see him snuggled by the warm fire.
Oh, Jimmy, it's sure time to cold. Look at that warm and cozy by the fire.
I don't like that. It's just snug as a bug. While we're out here freezing our beaks off.
Well, yakking and shivering ain't getting us anywhere. We'll get that no good wine when we come back. So long, Big Mama.
Oh, yeah, we're going south.
Goodbye, boys. See you next spring.
Over the long winter, Copper grew from a clumsy puppy into a full-grown hound. He loved tracking and hunting. Soon he learned to sniff out animal tracks, even in the deep snow.
Isn't he something, Chief?
Then it was spring again. Time to head for home.
I ain't got no job on the hunting man, and I'd rather have a dog than a dollar. So that's no bancho ringling a big hole. Give a little hoot and a holler.
Oh, come on, Chief. Just because you're not sitting up front, that ain't no reason to be a sore head. Chucks, if it weren't for you, Copper never turned into a good hunting dog. Yes, sirree. Now I got me the best two dogs there is. Right, Copper?
Look, Big Mama. Copper's back. Boy, has he grown big.
Uh-huh. And look at that big pile of skin he helped track down.
I know, Big Mama. He's a hunting dog now. You're right. And you're a puppy.
Oh, that won't make any difference. Copper's gonna be glad to see me.
Well, honey, just don't get your hopes too high.
Look, don't worry.
I'll be careful.
I'll go over tonight when Chief and the hunter are sound asleep.
Copper. Hey, Copper. It's me. Todd. I thought that was you, Todd. I heard you coming. Boy, you've really grown. You have too, Copper. I saw you coming back with Chief and the hunter. It's great to see you, Todd. But you know, you shouldn't be over here. You're going to get us both into a lot of trouble. Look, I just wanted to see you. We're still friends, aren't we? Todd, those days are over. I'm a hunting dog now. You better get out of here before old Chief wakes up. Oh, Chief, he doesn't worry me. Todd, I'm serious. You're fair game as far as he's concerned.
It's that fox again! After him, boys! Go get him!
Todd barely managed to stay one step ahead of Chief and the hunter. Quickly, he ducked under a wood pile and watched Chief run past. Copper's sensitive nose led him right to Todd.
Todd, I don't want to see you get killed. I'll let you go this one time.
Copper! Copper! Back it down, boy! Don't lose it!
As Copper led Amos in the wrong direction, Todd crept from the woodpile and raced across a high railroad trestle for home. But suddenly, there was Chief blocking his path. Todd turned back only to see a speeding train bearing down on him. He was trapped. Todd was small enough to duck safely beneath the train, but Chief was bumped off the tracks. He tumbled helplessly into the river below.
Chief! Chief? Oh, no! Poor Chief. It's all my fault. I shouldn't have let Todd go.
Todd, if it's the last thing I do, I'll get you for this.
Widow, get out here!
Why, Amos, what are you...
Where is he? I know he's in there.
Now, just a minute. You can't come barging onto my property, Amos Slade.
That fox of yours almost killed Chief, and I'm gonna get him. You can't keep him locked up forever.
Widow Tweed knew that Amos was right. The next morning, she put Todd into the truck. Together, they drove deep into the forest to a fenced game preserve.
We met, it seems, such a short time ago. You looked at me, needing me so. Yet from your sadness, our happiness grew. And I found out I needed you, too. I remember how we used to play. I recall those rainy days. The fires glowing. That carried us home. And now we're both alone. Goodbye, me seen forever. Farewell is like the end. But in my heart's the memory. And there will always be.
The widow carried Todd into a clearing. She gently put him down, gave him one last hug, then climbed sadly back into her truck and drove away. Todd felt helpless and alone. He had never learned how to get along on his own. He didn't know how to find food or shelter. When it began to rain, all the other animals scurried into their warm homes. But Todd had no place to go. Finally, he found a nice dry den. But an angry badger met him at the door.
Hold it, sonny! Back off!
I'm sorry, boy. Where do you think you're going?
Oh, excuse me. I was just trying to...
You barked in on somebody's house like you own it.
I honestly didn't know anybody lived here. And I...
Now, get off my property. Go on. Be it.
Morning, Todd.
Oh, hello, Big Mama.
Last night was pretty miserable for you, wasn't it, honey?
Just terrible.
Cheer up and look around. The forest is beautiful this morning.
After last night, nothing looks beautiful.
Wow.
Who is that?
Oh, just another fox. A lady fox.
Golly, is she beautiful? I wonder what her name is.
Well, why don't you go ask her?
Yeah, guess I will. I'll go up to her and I'll say, hi.
Hello.
May I call you by your first name?
Oh, sure, why not?
Thanks. What is your first name?
Fixie.
My name is Todd,
I just know you're going to love the forest. Listen, come on, let me show you around.
Sure.
When you have a natural attraction, you deserve a mutual reaction. You're going to get a whole lot of satisfaction. Is all you gotta do when you feel that natural affection lead you in the positive direction. You gotta stop showing off, start showing up with little old natural. Yes, you gotta appreciate the lady
And now that is a natural fact. Cause when you be yourself with a lady, you gonna get appreciated right back.
When the widow returned home without Todd, Amos knew what had happened.
She dropped that fox off in the game preserve. We'll get him.
Chief rested by the fire, his leg in a cast, while Amos loaded Copper and his deadly animal traps into the truck. They drove to the game preserve. Amos cut through the fence, ignoring a large sign nearby.
No hunting. Well, now, we ain't gonna do none of that, are we, Copper? We're just gonna get us a no-good fox. All right, boy, get tracking. Smell him out.
Copper quickly sniffed out a path that Todd and Dixie used.
Good work, boy. He'll be coming right through here, heading for water.
Amos skillfully set the traps along the path. He covered each one with leaves and twigs.
Amos, you crafty old coot. The devil himself couldn't have done no better.
What a beautiful morning, Vixie. You know, I've never been happier.
Oh, Todd, me too. Todd, wait a minute.
What is it, Vixie?
I don't want to go in there. It's too quiet. Todd, be careful.
Cautiously, Todd continued down the path. He began to feel the danger, too. His tail lightly brushed one of the hidden traps. Todd raced back up the path, traps snapping at his heels. Todd and Vixie ran up the hills past a roaring waterfall. Copper led Amos in pursuit. Suddenly, from the shadows stepped a huge bear. Amos raised his gun. The angry bear slapped it into the bushes. The frightened hunter staggered backwards and stepped into one of his own traps. Copper fought to protect his master. Fiercely, he lunged at the bear. But with a single powerful blow, Copper was knocked to the ground. Todd heard Copper's howl as it echoed up through the hills. He left Vixie in a safe place and raced to help his friend. Leaping onto the bear's back, Todd bit and scratched wildly. The enraged animal shook the fox free. Todd tumbled helplessly out onto a log which hung high over a raging waterfall. The huge bear charged after Todd, but his weight was too much for the old log. It split in half. Both animals plunged into the swirling waters below. After several moments, a head popped out of the water. It was Todd. Exhausted, he dragged himself to shore. But there was Amos, aiming right at him. Copper limped in front of the hunter's gun to protect Todd.
Come on, Copper. Get out of the way.
The faithful hound refused to leave Todd's side. Finally, Amos lowered his gun. He began to understand the deep bond of friendship between the two animals.
Well, come on, boy. Let's go home.
Copper followed Amos toward home. After a few steps, he looked back at Todd and smiled goodbye. They knew that they would always be very special friends. Todd returned to Vixie. They made their home together in the forest. Sometimes on warm summer nights, Todd and Vixie would sit on a hill overlooking Copper's home. The voices of a little fox and a little hound seemed to echo in the breeze.
Copper, you're my very best friend.
And you're mine too, Todd.
And we'll always be friends forever, won't we?
Yeah, forever.